my dear friends from the ICAP community. It's always a pleasure to be with the ICAP, and for years I've been coming over not to share anything from my side but to learn, because the quality of papers that are always read at the ICAP are perhaps the best. The question answer session was perhaps cut down, I don't know, maybe for the reason that people are hungry or what. Otherwise, intelligent questions always make a session more meaningful, and I would have sat till even 12 o'clock if the chairman would have allowed the continuation of the questions, because they help us a lot when we, especially this time when I go back, many questions have been raised, many objections have been raised. But I will tell you very briefly what was the concept of the budget while we were there this time. There were four things in our mind. Number one, we have to broaden the tax base. That's number one. Because we always hear that the manufacturing sector is being overburdened. When I go to overseas Chamber of Commerce, Shabar, you remember, they claim that we are only 170 members and we are contributing 33% of the total revenue. Now, that is their claim. Now, 66% from the manufacturing sector, about 13% from the salary sector, especially the gentleman who is very annoyed with the bonus amendment, and a very small part from the retail and the wholesale sector, which includes exporters. They are mostly not manufacturers, they are mostly, you would term them as traders, but mostly they are not manufacturers. The second thing that we had in mind was documentation. Now, what happened is that people are so used to not asking for any information or keeping records that unless we have documentation, how can we proceed? I will just give you one very small example of broadening and documentation, that we have up till now issued 3.3 million national tax numbers. Now, out of this 3.3 million national tax numbers, we have received only 1.5 million returns, out of which 19,000 are companies, 24,000 are AOPs, about 1.5 million are individuals including salaries. Now when we try and make an analysis as to how many NTNs have been obtained by people who are in business or in trading or in retail or in wholesale, there are more than 1 million taxpayers who have not filed a return. Then Mr. Zubair Motiwala says that why should we have intelligence and investigation wing? Because we are working on function line and we are not working after the people. So unless we have some intelligence gathering, how can we ensure this, that those 100,000 people, sorry, those 1 million people who have obtained an NTN, and they are doing some activity because the computer shows that there is some transaction going, how can we ensure them filing a return? This is something to be thought out. It's very easy to criticize, sir, but the fact remains that unless and until everybody over here ensures that the person with whom he's transacting is also as much a contributor to the national economy, things will not improve. Why should only 496 businessmen file a return and why not the others? Why should only the salaried people file a return? By the way, do you know this? That I was just telling Masood Bhai that the total contribution of the exporters up till now had been about 12 billion. While the salaried sector has already paid about 25 billion in tax bill. Which means that when the employer can contribute to the national economy in the sense that he deducts tax and deposit, why can't the traders do it? Why can't the shopkeepers do it? Why should Mr. Tahir Khalik be afraid that if unki van ko cigarette lene jaye to main usse number na lu? Why not? Everybody should play his part in the national economy. Simply saying that ye hamari national economy hamare to ye hai aur isme is tarah ho jayega, sir. Unless we take a step forward, you must have seen that we have not increased taxes this year. The basic theme was, once again, broadening.